Welcome back. It is day 10 on the Camino de Santiago, breaking it down with the help of Google Earth Pro. This is supplemental material to the vlog series that I did about 3 years ago. Today, day 10, is a short 21 kilometer day from Nájera to Santo Domingo de la Calzada. It's gonna be exposed terrain, exposed to the elements, very little shade inside, very little water as well, so you better bring some water or resupply in the two towns that we're gonna come across today. The first one is Azofra, followed by Cirueña. Today we're gonna be climbing just a little bit, not too much, but it's gonna be constant for the first 15 kilometers, and then it's just a nice downhill slope to Santo Domingo. We're gonna have two variants today. We can take the variant to the Monasterios de Suso y Yuso, which will take you an extra day to get to Santo Domingo, and I wish I would have known about this. I'll probably do it the next time I do the Camino Francés. The second one is just gonna be a short 6 kilometer variant just to avoid the highway if that's what you want, but if you do it, you're gonna miss a highlight of the day. By the way, today the Camino Vasco from Irún ends in Santo Domingo, and Irún is also the starting point of what? The Camino del Norte, which I did last year. I'm gonna leave a link up here in case you wanna check out that vlog series. So let's go over the Camino de Santiago as a whole one more time so that by the time you guys get there, you know it like the back of your hand. The Camino de Santiago stretches all the way from Saint John Pied de Port to Santiago de Compostela, close to 800 kilometers, and let's just leave it like that. But you can walk an extra 100 kilometers to the end of the world, to Fisterra, or you can also do Muxia, or both. I highly recommend you do both. We are on our second province of the trip. We started in Navarra, which ended in Logroño, and right now we're in La Rioja. It's gonna take us 2.5 days to get through. Short, but sweet. This is the wine region in Spain, and up ahead is what? Castilla y León. Castilla y León is divided into three provinces. You start with Burgos, followed by Palencia, and then León. After that, you enter Galicia. And Galicia, you have Lugo and A Coruña. As you can see, here's today's stage with the help of the elevation profile. And as I mentioned before, 21 kilometers, we're gonna be climbing slowly uphill, 255 meters to Cirueña, over 15 kilometers. By the time we get there, it's gonna be like the 75% of the day is gonna be behind us. Today, I left extremely early at 6:39 in the morning, and it was one of the coldest mornings on the entire Camino. It was near 0 Celsius or in the mid-30s. The forecast the day before, the night before, called for like 90% chance of snow. So I was getting a little bit worried because I did not bring winter gear other than the down jacket that I had, and it was showing in my lips and in my ears. So I was out the door and I went back to the same place where I had dinner last night, and that's where I had my breakfast, and then just continue heading out of the town. It was close to 7 in the morning when I made it to the Monasterio de Santa María la Real, the resting place of kings from Spain, one of the most iconic monasteries of the Camino, so make sure to visit the Panteón de los Infantes, the Tomb of Blanca of Navarra, and the Mausoleum of Diego López XIII, founder of Bilbao. On your way out, on your left hand side, you have the ruins of a castle, and on the right hand side, you have the Cruz Malpica. Not far from the town, 7:30, this is where I came across the first, here it is, the first marker that was completely different than the ones I've seen before. It said 582 kilometers to Santiago. It was like a wooden stake on the ground with the distance to it. You would only see a few on today's stage, and then magically they disappear. The landscape here is very peculiar. I loved it because there was nothing else like this on the entire Camino. Too bad that it was only like a very small stretch. As we go over, then we start descending. We get to see the views of what's up ahead today, which is just agricultural fields with the occasional vineyard in between. We get to cross over the Rio Valdacaña. 7:20 in the morning, there was a sign here to Ruta de las Clareles. I guess it's like a wine tour that you can do here. And then we make a right turn here. We start heading to the next town. As you can see, you're in exposed terrain, open fields. In my case, it was a very cold morning, but if you're doing this in the summer, it's gonna be hot, so you better come prepared. A lot of sun protection, a hat or a cap, and long sleeves, please. Making your way down, 7:34 in the morning, started to see those water canals, those irrigation canals, 580 kilometers to Santiago, walking. I did not get to film as much as I would love to on this day. It was a very short 5-minute vlog because it's kind of like a treadmill. You can walk and walk and the scenery kind of like remains the same. By the time we get to Azofra, we are the 25% of the way for today. I got to town at 8:09 in the morning. This is where I did the little joke with Shia LaBeouf with my neck gaiter. To me, at the time, it felt weird to have a buff walking through populated areas. Before this, I used to just use them on the mountains, but here I was walking through, sometimes through major cities, looking like a bandit. And now with the pandemic, I guess it's gonna become a staple of a pilgrim. By the way, if you like to support the channel in a small way and get something back, something tangible, you can visit my Teespring store and get one of these t-shirts, so you can get the Shia LaBeouf neck gaiter. The town of La Azofra owns its very existence to the Camino, to the pilgrims. Here you have a cemetery from the 12th century. You have Iglesia Nuestra Señora de los Ángeles. You have a couple of bars, restaurants, a pharmacy in case you need to resupply. There's a water fountain, but the water is not treated, so don't take water from there unless you have one of these. 8:17 in the morning, follow the yellow arrows outside the town. We go over the Rio Tuerto, and before we make a left turn, not far from the Camino, about 50 meters or so, there's the ruins of Fuente de los Romeros. Did not have a clue that it was there, but now you can see where it is. You can go ahead and visit it. From here, you have the second variant that I told you about. In case you don't want to trail the main road on this side, you can take this variant. It is about a kilometer or 0.8 of a kilometer longer, but you're out into the countryside. On the downside, you will miss the Rollo de Azofra or El Picote, which is not far from there. It is a picote from the 14th century, and as I read, they used to hang prisoners from here. It was 8:33 in the morning, and then continue walking past Canal de la Margen. This is what you see here today, vineyards, fields, water channels, and slowly going uphill. And then we trail the main road, but just for a little bit. It's not really too bad. Go by this roundabout, and then we leave it behind and we go back out into the country road. Once again, we're at the halfway point of the day. I met one of the pilgrims that I have walked with at the beginning of the stage. I think the last time that I saw him was when I got to Puente La Reina. We walked all the way to Santo Domingo, but he decided to continue on walking because he had done the Camino de Santiago many, many times throughout his life. So every time, he offsets the stages where he stays so that it feels completely different to him. He was giving me a world of information about the Camino, so I learned a lot from him. Just before you make it to this golf course here, which is something that catches you by surprise, this is where the variant rejoins the Camino, the official Camino, and also where that detour that you could have taken to the monasteries in this town is where it joins. So here you have two variants joining at the Camino. Made it to the golf course at 10:09 in the morning, and I had a snack at the golf course with my friend before leaving this neighborhood. Water fountain here right next to the pool, so in case it is the summer, you can go in there, I guess, probably paying a small fee, and you can take a dip in the pool. There's a rest area. And then you head to the old town, Cirueña. This is the highest point of the day today. There are a few albergues here in Cirueña, but other than that, I think there's not much. And then after the runabout, you're at the 75% of the day today. And from here, we're just doing like a small climb. I think this was like the highest point I flew my drone from here almost 11 in the morning, got some cool shots of all these fields because that's what you will see in every direction. And from here, we're going all the way down to Santo Domingo de la Calzada. We get into like the industrial area of the town. I stopped filming once I flew my drone and I did not start it again well after I got to the Albergue. But here you can see, here's the industrial section that every town has. And at this runabout is where the Camino Basco and the Camino Francés join. I'll probably do that one day in the future. If by the time you're seeing this video, I already did it, I'll probably leave a link right here at the top. But it's gonna be a while because the list is long and it keeps growing because everybody keeps suggesting amazing trips that I should do and I wanna do them all. So you enter this historic city. I got to the Albergue around noon, settled in, took my bath, you know, already the drill. I got a top bunk bed. It was the first Albergue where I saw one of those lock boxes where you just put a euro as a deposit and you can leave your valuables in there. Something that is much appreciated, especially for me when I go out to explore the town. I don't want to carry all my electronics with me, so I just leave them there. Headed to the main plaza, 1:34 in the afternoon, to have lunch. And I had lunch at a bar here facing the plaza, facing the city hall. The plaza dates back to the 16th century and open markets and bullfights were common here. It was 2 in the afternoon when I was at the Albergue checking on my clothes to see if they were dry. There were a few chickens there in the backyard and all of a sudden the weather shifted and it started getting very windy. It started raining and there was a little bit of snow mixed in there. So I had to take all my clothes. They were wet, they were not gonna dry. There was an actual laundromat across the street, but at that time, I wasn't doing that. I was just doing them in the Albergue. This is something that I learned later on. I learned it on the Via Francigena. I was relying a lot on the public laundromats. They're a little bit more expensive, but sometimes you have no choice. This would have been the case here. What I should have done is talk to all the pilgrims and see if they wanted to pull in or are close and just do one wash and save a lot of money by doing it that way. At 4:24, I decided to get some drone shots of the city and I left the wall enclosure here. By the way, this town has the largest wall enclosure in La Rioja. Most of it has collapsed, but you still have the ruins, which are amazing. I got shots of that. I saw a white stork on top of one of the towers. I got shots of the cathedral, which, by the way, you should visit because it has the remains of Santo Domingo, hence the name of the town. It was 8 o'clock and I went to a local restaurant to get my menu del día, the pilgrim menu. I had a mixed salad, steak with fries, half a bottle of red wine and flan, and all of this was for $12.70. A lot of food, but you do need it because you're burning a lot of calories. I think you're burning around 3,000 to 5,000 calories a day here. So no matter what you eat, you're gonna lose a ton of weight. I lost on this trip about 17 pounds or about the same as what I was carrying on my backpack. So by the time I got to the end of the world, it was as if I was walking without a backpack. So that was the end of day 10 on the Camino Francés. I hope you enjoy today's stage. Tomorrow, we have a 22-kilometer day to Belorado, another beautiful village. And I hope you're enjoying the annotations. If you don't see this, then you're not watching the video on YouTube and you should head over there right now. So I guess I'll see you guys on the next video.